and try to pick something.
Amen.
my fault.
Oh, it's no trouble. Ethel just moved right into the guest room.
And Red, where did your uncle put you?
You mean that's my old tool shop over the garage?
That place is a greasy dump.
Well, no more.
Picture this. Sky blue wallpaper, chocolate brown carpet.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
When will Mr. McCormick be joining us?
Mr. McCormick won't be joining us.
My husband and I are separated.
He ran off to find himself.
Friend, please.
Bye, bye. I'm paying my toll house fare. Lulu, you can't find your burn. Everybody would be in your kitchen.
Mr. McCormick, Eleanor wants to show us what heaven tastes like.
Call me Ethel, please.
Only if you call me bye.
Save me a cookie, Ethel.
So, Rand, all set for school tomorrow?
We took care of that last week. Coach, you're up getting registered.
Oh, Reverend, did you hear that new English teacher was planning to introduce some vulgar modern novel into our American Lit course?
Slaughterhouse Five. Yes, Coach, I received several calls.
Slaughterhouse Five? Cool book. Cover to cover, that is one bitchin' store. Slaughterhouse Five? Yeah, it's a classic.
Do you read much?
Well, Coach, maybe in another town it's a classic.
In any town, of course.
Tom Sawyer's a classic.
Daddy, oh, excuse me. Daddy, my see the girls are going for burgers tonight. Can I?
Tomorrow's a school day.
Daddy.
Ask your mother.
Oh, we already have Reverend Moore. She said it was okay with her. It was okay with you. So is it okay with you?
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. Great sermon, Reverend.
Thank you, Rusty.
Remember the part when you explained what Jesus would have thought of rock and roll?
I sure do.
My mama was all like, hallelujah!
My praise indeed. Gentlemen. Let's see.
I, on the other hand, thought my daddy was never going to shut up, Ariel. You're just going to have to talk to him.
Why? He never listens to me. And... Oh.
Welcome to Beaumont.
Oh. You are cute, 22. Isn't he cute?
Uh-huh.
And many know he's cute, don't you think, 22?
Uh-huh.
It's your father.
Hold it. Take a number and get in line.
Huh? Behind who?
Church lady here. She's got that looking right.
That's the what you're talking about.
Where are you going?
Wouldn't you like to know?
Thank you. again, Reverend?
Your mother thought you might be cold.
Ethan! Reverend?
Listen, fella, around here you push somebody. They push back. Next thing you know, you got two people pushing. Get it?
Now, let me ask you something. They sell men's clothes where you got that hat.
What is that, some kind of stupid joke?
No, that's a really good joke. That's it.
I'm gonna kill you.
Please kill me. I'm killing me. Killing me. That's the most exciting thing I've heard since I hit town. Ren McCormick. And you are?
Willard. Willard here.
Willard, what do you do around here for a good time?
Yeah, well, what do we do?
Nothing! I don't know what we have to do. I don't believe that any of you. People try to slow me down, say for you reach. Keep that and cheap up. I can't stand it. Oh, okay, I get it.
looks on the new kid. Mr. Hewitt, would you inform your friend?
It's against the law.
Dancing? Get out. Shut up.
Principal Clark, sir, Ren is very sorry. He was ignorant of our local law, and I will inform him of his ignorance.
And I will see both of you in my office after school. I'm sure we all have places to be.
Willard, the way you spoke to Principal Clark, wow, that's like the longest sentence you've ever made.
Hey, chin up,
McCormick.
It's such a turn on watching this guy fly in the face of authority, isn't it, Wendy Jo?
Uh-huh. Was he serious?
Serious as a heart attack.
Dancing is against the law.
It has been for 5.5 years ever since the accident.
What accident?
The Tommy Bridge accident.
We're just making a joke about it. Right?
Hey!
Hey!
What happened?
Well, there were these four kids from Beaumont, his kids that we all grew up with, and they were driving back from this big dance over in Baylor County across the Tawny River.
There was a fog that night, and you couldn't see 10 feet in front of you, and who knows, maybe they got wild.
Maybe they weren't paying attention, but the road into the bridge and lost control of the car.
Oh, I hate this part. When they hit the brakes, the car slammed into a curb. It skidded across the bridge and crashed right through the guardrail. They dropped 35 feet into the river. It took 15 men on the police barge 2 days to drag that car out. When Sheriff Deacon published the autopsy report in the local paper, everybody went nuts. He claimed there was alcohol in their blood and marijuana.
And that's when everyone got righteous and started blaming everything. Liquor, drugs, rock and roll.
And dance.
You got it. We could get the town council to call us in.
And they passed the law.
Wait, Reverend Moore has that kind of power?
Reverend Moore?
He is the power. He is the law.
Man, how can you stand to live like this?
Practice. Years of practice.
It's not like Chicago. It must be so cool to live in a city where you can walk down the street and get mugged by people you don't even know.
I miss that. I thought living in a small town was going to be perfect. One big happy family.
Let me tell you about that. His tongue's wagging every time you make a move.
There's fingers pointing every time they turn around. There's heads shaking the minute you cross the line.
And there's eyes everywhere.
Careful what you do. Someone's on to you. Careful what you do. Careful what you say.
Someone with the perfect view. You. to know the difference between a wrestling match and a street fight.
Oh, Mr. Coach,
the wrestling match is usually one-on-one.
Now, that's enough out of you. This is the third time in 20 weeks that you've been dragged into my office. I'm suspending you for the rest of the team. Indefinitely. Ha!
It's not even a bus.
And you got fired. You know, Mom, there are more other employees that answer the phone.
Lulu, don't use that to me. F O hush. Not no
Forgive me, Pumpkin, but it's one thing after another with this boy.
What happened, sweetie?
I don't know. Pop, don't play catch, mister, because Lulu didn't change for a dollar. Mr. Beinecke goes nuclear and accuses me of stealing.
Well, that's because everything you do makes people suspicious.
Are you on drugs?
No! Why don't you risk me? I'm sure you don't even talk for everything in my room.
Grant, apologize to your uncle.
Now, look, young man. I know that I'm not your father.
You can say that again.
Grant!
Don't say anything, Ethel.
I can't not say anything. I don't know how to do that, Grant.
Well, you know, once I realize we're guests in your air. Right now, just don't say anything.
Never say
thank you.
a book. Clip notes. Chipotle.
It's even better in the book. There's all these mice on horseback jousting and storming the castle.
Oh, we forget a guy in an overall riding pickup trucks.
Hot Willard.
Hi, how y'all doing? Hey, Rusty.
Hey, Willard.
Well, see ya.
Hey, Willard, that's it. You two are pathetic.
When are you two going to have a real conversation?
Lulu's not capable of a real conversation.
I kind of like that the guy.
Come on. Whoa! Hey, Red, how's the new job?
Well, I haven't been fired until today, my second day.
Wow, you may have found your future.
Maybe. What can I get you?
Diet Coke.
Diet Coke. I'll have the Lulu burger, don't fight cheap film. Extra meat, Lulu burger, fries. And a Diet Coke.
Ariel, what's your pleasure?
It's not on the menu.
Oh,
I trust he's confirmed with Ariel, you were a dead man.
She doesn't even remember me.
Well, that uniform makes you look like such an asshole, it's easier to pick you out.
I was looking for a fight.
Mama says it's my nature.
Shut up and tell me what you know about Ariel.
Well, I know she's been kissed a lot.
Baby, she was onto you like a hot on slump. Get out.
Ariel likes trouble, and you definitely showed everybody in this town that you are T-R-U-B-A.
Memorize the bus schedule.
You told us you read just to escape to other worlds.
Exactly. In books, I get to meet guys who amaze me.
What about
Red? What about it?
Well, I think he's a handsome.
Cute, maybe.
But can he really compete with Chuck Cranston, the rugged, dangerous high school dropout slash drug dealer who recently evicted from a trailer park?
I don't think so.
Beats me. I think she's good looking and all, but I never know what the hell she's talking about. She talks faster than any girl I ever met.
That's because you make her horny.
You think?
If I can only find a guy that makes the person move.
If I could only find a guy who, when he went to kiss me goodnight, he'd take the toothpick out of his mouth.
If I could only find a guy.
Where have all the good men gone, and where are all the gods? Yes, we fight Hercules to fight the rising odds.
Why, Gina?
Hey, you're not like you're making a fool out of me.
And why should you? You do such a good job at it yourself.
Shut up, Russell.
You'll be joining these ladies for dinner.
What did I say, maybe? What am I talking to myself?
No, you're right. Just calm down.
Somebody calm down? Don't tell me what to do. Look, I know what your friends think of me. That's bullshit. I'm the best party in this town, baby. Those three dogs ought to be tied in front of the porch. Let's go.
No.
Ariel, get on the bike.
No.
Excuse me?
I said no, Chuck. What part of that don't you understand?
I get it. Preacher's daughter saying no makes me hot. Save me.
Chuck, stop it!
Please, should know.
I mean, this is none of your business.
Brandon, don't.
Ariel, who invited this clown?
Oh, I'm sorry, we haven't been formally introduced. Brandon McCormick!
Get your hand out of my face and get your face out of my sight!
Hey, Chuck, you're looking for a fight? Well, let's party! Me and the guys were just discussing the comfort and safety of one of your valued customers.
Yeah, that's funny.
Preston, your hall is in a handicap bargain, which is a space reserved for people with physical, not emotional disabilities.
You've seen the last of me, McCormick.
Could I please kick his ass?
Miller, what does your mama say? Before you make a fist, make sure it's your five.
Yes, sir.
Well, this is not your five.
I know, ma'am. I'll turn on my skates.
Listen to me. I'll see you here after school tomorrow.
Really?
Yeah. Now, give me a push on it.
Yes, ma'am.
Woo! Thank you.
You are either very brave or very stupid.
Which do you think?
I haven't made up my mind. You want to see something?
Don't you have a curfew?
My daddy invented it. Come on.
Or we don't.
Don't think.
Preacher, not a teacher.
When you're good, it's the same thing. My dad used to be real good.
Yeah, changed.
His mind. He closed it.
I know.
He used to be so open, so inspiring. I've seen him give people hope and hope is gone. I've watched him change people's lives.
If you love him so much, why do you want to take him off?
I didn't say I love him.
But do I know what you mean? My dad, if he was here right now, you know what I'd say?
What?
How could you be so stupid to leave Mommy? I hate you!
Feel better?
I'm not sure.
You want to kiss me?
Someday.
Someday? What do you mean someday?
You've been kissed a lot. I'm afraid I'd suffer by comparison.
You don't think much of me, do you?
Oh. I think of you more than I expected. Come on. I'll walk you home.
Somebody's eyes are watching. How's it going? Principal Clark, Coach Dunbar.
Hi, Miss Dunbar.
Mrs. Moore.
Welcome, Ren.
Well, poker night.
Oh. Ariel, all this time we thought you were upstairs in your room doing your homework.
It's hard to impose a curfew on the young people of my congregation when I can't seem to enforce one in my own home.
What's that old expression? It's the shoemaker's children who always go barefoot.
Well,
you should come out to your room.
It's a rare talent.
I'm going to take that as a compliment.
Mr. McCormick, you seem to confuse sarcasm with humor.
I believe this is yours.
Ren, thanks for, you know.
Working your room?
Yeah, that too.
So, Ren, Thanksgiving your house, I'll bring the cranberry sauce.
Somebody's eyes are seeing you come and go.
What? Really good?
Yeah, it did.
I get nervous. I go crazy and I end up putting my foot in my mouth.
Your mother said you were good at it, but I had no idea. Good night.
Because he's a troublemaker. Everyone says he's belligerent, but he has no respect for
us. Who is everyone, Daddy? The Bridge Club?
Eric, what am I going to do with you?
Me? Daddy, lately all you do is look for the worst in people, and of course you find it.
My, where did that come from?
From you, Daddy. The world is evil, and Ariel has to be locked away in the tower.
Well, that's a little melodramatic. Now, don't you think?
No, I don't. Daddy, you make me feel like a prisoner, and I hate it.
Someone's got to put a foot down.
I didn't say anything.
I don't enjoy being her cheer. I don't relish telling her no. But then I think, what if I fail her? How can I just let her go? I strive to be a good preacher. I try not to go overboard. But then I think, if I can't reach her, how can I face my Lord? Can help me shoulder my load? Every day's a struggle still. Someone's got to take the high road. If I don't, who will? I became a man of God to do his work, spread his word, to ease some pain and dry some tears. That was a plan.
I encourage you to stay away from this guy. I've been asked to keep an eye on you.
My father called you?
Surprise, surprise.
Cooperate, it'll make our lives much easier.
Gee, if my daddy makes a call, can you get off of my back?
That mouth of yours probably made your daddy walk out in the first place.
Hey, man, just turn to 10. Mom says, get
to 10. You'd be wise to take your friend's advice. Ariel, get back to practice. And McCormick, get down, give me 30.
You're joking.
Oh, you're right. Make it 50.
Well, he's not faking. Coach is really hurt.
Thank you for your diagnosis, Dr. Miller. You can give me 50 as well. As a matter of fact, you can all give me 50. Courtesy of Mr. McCormick. Just do it! 1, 2, I can't hear you.
3, 4.
46 more.
5, 6.
On 7, 8. Yeah, the rent, thanks a lot.
Sorry to be but this whole damn town is so wound up.
Oh, man.
There isn't no place to blow up any steam.
You said it.
How about we go to the clubs?
Maybe we ought to take the coach to dance.
We'll look at ourselves in
water. What do you think?
Humans.
What?
We're going to throw hands. We ought to throw a kick-ass party that's going to knock my right off his track.
You're just asking for a fight.
Bring it on!
Are you ready to take on Reverend Moore?
I'll take on anybody.
What about the town council?
I'll fight City Hall! There is one thing we're fighting for. It's freedom.
No shit. No wonder you're so eager to do some tail shaking.
Thank you.
tell Ariel that?
Yes, Chuck, I told her every time you called.
Thanks. I guess she must be busy, you know?
She and the girls went over to Wendy Jo's to study.
I was just over there. They said she left hours ago.
Oh?
Who is it by?
Mr. Cranston. Evening, Reverend. I was just looking for Ariel.
Isn't it a bit late, Mr. Cranston?
Yes, sir. That is why I am surprised she's not at home.
So am I. Good night, Mr. Cranston. And next time, please remember, we have a front door for guests.
Yes, sir.
Where is she?
She told me she was going to Wendy Jo's. Don't bother calling. She's not there.
Did you know about this?
No, I did not.
So how does it feel, Vi, now that she's lying to you?
I'm not saying anything until I hear an explanation from her.
It was frightening enough when she was running around with Chuck Cranston. Now she's out in the middle of the night with a punk who is campaigning to challenge me and the entire town council. How long are you defending her?
I'm not defending her. We're not on opposite sides here, are we? Or are we?
Where were you?
Rusty and I were
just...
We know you weren't at Wendy Jones.
I can't believe you were checking up on me.
Sweetie, how do we know you're not sick or hurt?
I am concerned for your well-being.
Well, how come when I'm at home you're never interested in what I'm thinking or how I feel? But the minute I walk out that door, wham! Suddenly, you're the concerned parent.
She doesn't mean that, Shaw.
Stop taking her side. She has to start answering for herself.
I don't know what any good that would do. You never listen to me any more than you listen to her.
Shut up. I know.
I don't understand what's happening. I don't know what to do anymore.
Yes, you do. Can you find it in your heart to forgive her? Can you stop and see there's part of her that's trying to obey? While part of her is dying to run away, can you hear what she's trying to say? Can you find it in your soul to accept her? If she stumbles on your holy path, do you have to recommend? Or are there ways to make her understand? Does it ever cross your mind that I miss you? Is there any chance we'll find the joy that we share at the start? Can you remember what you felt before that feeling fell apart? Can you find it in your heart? Somewhere far behind.
speaking to the town council, so don't hold me. One more time.
Citizens of Beaumont, the town is only as small as the minds of the people who live there. So think big and hurry up!
Wow! Man, that's not wrong!
We're not saying this because it's bad. It's just that it's no good.
Dad, what am I supposed to say? I've written it 9 times.
Here's the thing. You'll be facing Reverend Moore and some of the stubbornest people in town.
You got plenty of people boiling mad.
Yeah, folks pick a side.
They're not picking you up.
Then who am I kidding? This whole thing has gotten way out of hand. Maybe I ought to just forget it.
Now, we don't mean to discourage you.
After all the work we've done.
All the flyers we've passed out.
Everybody at school is climbing the wall.
Hang in there. You just got to rethink your approach.
Right.
Now, Mama says. Everything I ever learned that gets me through the worst, I learned at my mama's knee. Now, anytime I'm turned around, I turn to Mama first. And you'd be wise to memorize what Mama says to me. Now, Mama ain't been wrong yet. Mama says, don't use a toaster while standing in the shower. Now, who can argue with that? Mama says, don't hold your breath for longer than an hour. The woman knows where it's at. And Mama says, it doesn't matter if you're a king or you're a clown.
Once.
our ceiling. I don't know what that's about. And Mama says, don't you
I hear my heart would beating.
and on behalf of most of the senior class of Beaumont High, I move that local ordinance 416, the law against public dancing within the Beaumont town limits, be abolished.
And I'm Willard Hewitt of 385 Cloverdale Road would like to second that motion. Thank you.
May I have the floor, please?
Certainly, Reverend.
Mr. McCormick, perhaps you view the law as a personal offset. In fact, law is the public expression of the standard which a community sets for itself. Now, even if I didn't believe that your enterprise was fraught with spiritual peril, which I do, I am not naive about the activities which these events foster. The consumption of alcohol, the use of drugs, the new behavior.
But what I understand what this town has been through.
No, I don't think you do, son, because if you did, you would have never encouraged your classmates to reopen the wounds we have healed. Now, I don't wish to be dogmatic. If there's anyone here who can convince me that there is no danger in your raucous party plans, I will certainly reconsider my stand. But for now, no. I can't condone it.
I believe that a vote is in order.
Will all those...
Excuse me. Isn't there any kind of discussion?
Sit down. I believe Mr. McCormick has a right to be heard.
Up till now, I've been real proud of keeping my opinion to myself. But, honey, if I don't say something, I'm going to bust.
What's there to say? I got cream.
You never had a prayer.
Come on.
Red, while you were lobbying to throw a party in your pants, which I loved, don't get me wrong, I was watching the faces of the town council. I promise you, Shaw Moore had those votes locked up before he walked in here tonight.
He told them how to vote.
You can still be shocked. I love that about you.
He's a man of God.
He's a man, and you were railroaded.
Damn it! Pisses me off!
God! Now listen, Reverend Moore said he would only reconsider if someone convinced him there was no danger in your raucous party plan.
Raucous party plan? Can you believe these guys? What am I going
to
do?
Make him reconsider. Go talk to him.
Yes, now.
If you don't, you're never going to make peace with this town.
Yeah, what do I say?
Beats me. Just remember, Shaw's real smart and real stubborn, but so are you. I wish I could watch, but I have to go home and post down your Aunt Lulu and Uncle Wes.
I love you, Mom.
You have no choice.
Now go! Congratulations.
Can I help you, Mr. McCormick?
The look on your face, I could ask you the same thing.
This was not a pleasant evening for any of us.
By the way, did you fix tonight's voting?
What?
Before the meeting, did you already know how the town council was going to vote?
Friend, you are too young to understand what dangers exist in the world.
Maybe, but you haven't answered my question.
Friend, this is more than a question of a dance.
It is, isn't it? I mean, for you and for me. Reverend, I didn't just want to throw a party.
What did you think you were doing?
When I came into this town, I felt like my life was over. Maybe I needed to feel I could do something. Like I could change things. Reverend, I'm sorry. I guess I just picked the wrong fight.
Then we finally drop this.
Hey, the votes are in. That's been done for me.
Yes, it has. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Yeah, just one more question, sir. Does that make things better? I mean, really.
You don't stop, do you?
Reverend, I know about your son.
You know nothing about my son.
You're right. I only know that there was a car crash, and I know that doesn't make any sense.
I don't ask for it to make sense. I believe in the will of God.
Yeah, if you miss your son as much as I still miss my dad, it's gotta hurt. I keep trying to bring Dad back. 100 times every day, but I can't, you know?
I know only too well.
I can see that. And you know what? Ariel can see it too, maybe better than anyone.
Don't speak to me about my daughter.
Why do you think she does the thing she does just to scare you? She keeps trying to get to you.
I don't want to continue this discussion. I believe we've said all that needs to be said.
No, listen. If you don't start accepting Ariel, you're going to lose her. Maybe not like Bobby, but you're going to lose her.
I would like to be alone.
Sure, you already are.
For something
the world fill up with lies.
Bobby, that's a million questions. Like, Daddy, how many is the biggest number? Or Daddy, why do I have a thumb?
And I confess, I didn't always have the answers. I didn't always know which way was true. Nevertheless, I've always tried to lead with love. That's all that any father can do. As the years went by, we had our differences, but who doesn't? Even if the friendship wasn't all it was before, we shared a lot. And who'd have thought that so much joy could vanish in a blink? Whoever stops to think, and in that final moment, who knows what the thought? The questions come too late, and linger far too long, and I confess, I don't always have the answers, I don't always know which way is true. Nevertheless, I always try to meet with love. That's all that any father can do.
And look.
Look! What do I do? This boy comes to me, this father's child. I scoff at his pain and I send him away. My daughter speaks up and I shout her down. I won't hear a word of what she has to say. My voice reaches out and I turn my back. I send her to bed without even a kiss.
Now here's the deal.
I can throw a clean sheet over the front seat of the pickup so we don't end up smelling like dogs.
Uh-huh.
That is the kind of fits I can work the pant legs with duct tape.
I love where this is going.
Mom can hook us up one of them croissants.
A corsage?
You know them.
You're painting a picture for me, aren't you? I see a rescue truck that smells bad, a taped up brown suit, and me wearing a corsage there, and God knows what.
What do you think?
Was there a dance there someplace?
Yes, ma'am. You wanna?
Will it have a love to?
Don't even think about it!
Sean, you were wonderful this morning.
Really?
Yes. It reminded me of how much I've missed you. Us.
I hope you never doubt that I love you. If that's hard to figure out sometimes, then I apologize. But you are dearer to my life than you could ever realize. If I try to make amends, can you teach me how to sing? Can you find